New Hampshire's Connecticut River near Hanover, New Hampshire. I'm with my good friend, Carlton Schumacher. We're going to catch some fish, and then Carlton's going to cook us some shore lunch.
Oh, actually, I got him. Still.
Good job. Chain pickerel? Mini northern.
All right, Mark. We're in business.
Found a fish. We can find some walleye. So we caught some fish. What are you going to do with them?
We're going to blacken the fish. We're going to do some potatoes with some fiddleheads today. We have some nice fresh fiddleheads for the season. And we'll probably put some garlic and some thyme in there. Some blackened fish will be great. I made some homemade tartar sauce. We should have a nice little lunch.
Excellent. You want them to have a nice tight curl with no feathers coming off the stalk.
Bacon, butter, oil.
This is regular bacon. I'm going to just render it in the pan. The bacon fat will help cook the potato.
You can only smell sizzle.
I know, it's so good. If you don't pre-cook potatoes, they tend to be very difficult to cook through. They tend to get really dark on the outside. So that's one of the secrets to camp cooking. You should do as much prep work as you can, because once you're out here and you're enjoying yourself, I want to be doing as little cooking, as much eating, as much fishing as I can. I'm going to add a little bit of oil to it. Normally adding cold oil to a hot pan would be bad, but since the pan is nice and warm, it heats up really fast. And that helps to get that nice crust, kind of like what you do with a french fry. In a few minutes, I'll put some onions in, put some thyme. I'll add a little garlic, and we're going to get ready and do our fish. I'm going to put the onion in now. Eventually, it'll cook through, but right now, I'm just going to get it a little bit softer than it is. So I'm going to leave those alone. And now I'll work on the fish here a little bit. We'll start getting it out. There are probably no better fish to eat in fresh water than a walleye.
I agree.
That's the best.
And you add walleye and fiddleheads, and you're just saying spring in New Hampshire.
Here it is. Oh, these are nice fillets, Mark. Good job. Put some garlic in. Put the garlic in, eventually I'll mix that up in there, but if you put it on that cast iron, black garlic is about the worst thing that you could do to this.
There's
color and the flavor of
spring. Look at those guys, we just got those.
Some fresh cracked pepper.
Fresh cracked pepper. The secret to getting this blackening is to get the pan smoking hot. You're gonna see this get like wisps of smoke coming off, and it's gotta be rocking hot, and then what you do is put it on for just a couple minutes, and as long as you get one side blackened, the other side almost will cook through. All right.
Beautiful.
All right, these are getting happy. Now to blacken something, you actually need to coat it with oil before you put it in the pan. If you put it in the pan, you're essentially pan frying it. This is a medium spiced blend. It's hard to find walleyes anywhere else.
Let's do this.
Woo, that's hot. Yeah.
It smells wonderful.
Yeah, we're going to be eating pretty quick here, which I'm happy about.
Oh.
Look at that.
I think we're going to have to go out and catch some more fish.
I think I'm okay with that. How hungry are you, Mark?
I can eat all that.
Got a lot here. Mark, can you grab some silverware for us?
Certainly.
Some homemade tartar sauce. This is good. Blackened it just right.
It's perfect.